This video is about the unloader valve on the pressure washer. You are probably watching this video because you have a loss of water pressure from the pressure washer, or the engine on the pressure washer stalls when the trigger is released on the shutoff gun. The pump on the pressure washer is a positive displacement pump and does not have a means of regulating pressure. In other words, what goes in must come out. The unloader valve is what regulates or controls the water pressure. The unloader valve not only regulates the water pressure, but goes into a bypass mode or unloads to redirect the water from the pump when the trigger is released on the shutoff gun. The unloader valve is located on the outlet end of the pressure washer, where the high pressure hose hooks to the pressure washer, also identifiable by its black knob. The most common symptom of a worn or malfunctioning unloader valve is loss of water pressure, but if the unloader valve does not go into bypass mode when the trigger is released on the shutoff gun, it can cause the engine to stall. Before proceeding, you need to verify that you are providing plenty of water to the pressure washer. The pressure washer requires a minimum of 4 gallons per minute of water. Don't assume that because you had a good water source at the beginning of your day, that you have a good source of water now. Recheck your garden hoses to assure that they are in good condition and not crimped or restricted. Someone may have run over your garden hoses or parked a skid on them. Check the garden hose screen for blockage. And check your water filter screen for blockage. You can easily measure your water supply. Simply take an empty 5-gallon bucket and measure how much water flows into the bucket in 1 minute. It should be a minimum of 4 gallons in 1 minute. After you have verified your water supply, you need to check the water pressure coming out of the pressure washer. Install your company supplied pressure gauge between the high pressure hose and the unloader valve. Always use a 0-degree nozzle tip in the wand while testing. A worn nozzle tip can affect your pressure readings. Assure that the throttle control lever on the engine is set at the full position. Turn on the water to the pressure washer. Pull the trigger on the shutoff gun and start the pressure washer. With the trigger pulled on the shutoff gun, you should have a 2,500 pounds pressure reading, give or take 100 pounds. A difference in water pressure of 300 pounds or more can indicate a worn unloader valve, and the next step is to replace the unloader valve. To remove the unloader, you first need to remove the high pressure hose from the outlet fitting and the test gauge if it was installed during testing. Next, you loosen the clamp on the bypass hose. Slide the clamp down the bypass hose and remove the bypass hose. Remove the soap pickup 1/4-inch clear line from the soap injector. Notice that the fitting at the bottom of the unloader is part of the unloader and is removed with the unloader. Support the elbow fitting underneath the unloader as you break loose the unloader. And screw the unloader off. When replacing the unloader valve, you need to ensure that the inlet and outlet fittings are the same configuration. You may need to transfer the inlet, outlet, and bypass fittings to the replacement unloader valve to match your configuration. Most unloader valves have multiple inlet and outlet ports for the different applications. There is also a soap injector that attaches directly to the outlet port of the unloader valve. If you received the replacement unloader valve from the company, then the soap injector is included with the unloader. If you purchased a new unloader valve from an outside source, then you will need to purchase a soap injector that fits the new unloader. Once you verify that the replacement unloader valve is plumbed the same and has a soap injector, then you are ready to reinstall the replacement unloader valve onto the pressure washer. We're ready to reinstall our unloader valve back onto our pressure washer. I'm going to make sure you clean the threads on the elbow fitting and install 2 to 3 wraps of Teflon tape. Assure that the threads in the bottom of the unloader are clean, and then thread the unloader valve back onto the pressure washer. Now be aware that the threads in the unloader and the elbow fitting are pipe thread, so you need to be aware that as you tighten of where you want to stop so that you orient the unloader in the proper position. If you go too far beyond your stop point, then you're going to have to remove the unloader, put a fresh wrap of Teflon tape on the elbow fitting, and start over. You always want to support your fitting underneath the unloader as you tighten the unloader. Next, you're going to install your bypass hose. You'll want to trim a half inch or maybe an inch off your bypass hose so that you have a fresh hose or fresh connection here. I've already done that on our sample here. So you're going to install your bypass hose, slide the hose clamp up, tighten the hose clamp on the bypass hose. Next, install your soap hose. And again, I've already trimmed this. You'll want to trim about an inch off of this so you have a nice fresh connection for the barb fitting. This completes the replacement of the unloader valve. Next, we're going to check the pressure of the unloader valve and adjust it as necessary. We're going to check the pressure setting on our new unloader. You have to reinstall your pressure gauge, your high pressure hose, along with the shutoff gun, the wand, the zero tip nozzle. Turn the water on, pull the trigger on the shutoff gun, and start the engine. Assure that the throttle lever is in the full position. Your pressure reading should be 2,500 pounds, give or take 100 pounds. After you get your reading, you can shut the pressure washer off. If you need to adjust the pressure setting, you will need to remove the cap on the black knob. There's a jam nut inside the cap that you have to remove. Remove the black knob, turning it counterclockwise. Remove the spring and the washer. There's a washer right on top. These two jam nuts is what sets your pressure. You may want to make a reference mark on one of the jam nuts. Each turn, each full turn of a jam nut is going to change your pressure roughly 200 pounds. So what you'll want to do is hold the one jam nut in position while you break the other jam nut loose. And if you want to increase your pressure, you turn down or clockwise. And if you want to decrease your pressure, you'll turn counterclockwise. Hold your jam nut in, or your nut in position while you tighten the other jam nut against it. Install your spring and your washer and reinstall the black knob, making sure that you screw this all the way down tight. You're actually tightening the black knob against those jam nuts. You can restart the power washer at this point and recheck your pressure setting. Once the proper pressure is obtained, then you can reinstall your jam nut. And the black cap. And you have adjusted the pressure on your new unloader.